concept launch of Bharat One. Without wasting much time, let me introduce you to our panel members. Mr. Prashant B, Lead Strategy and Alliances, National Payments Corporation of India. Mr. Rahul Tandon, Associate Vice President, National Payments Corporation of India. Mr. Abhinav Jain, Co-Founder and MD, Fraser Enterprises. Mr. Nirlesh Gopali, CTO, VoiceKey. Mr. Ritesh Kothari, Technical Architect, VoiceKey. Mr. Vinay Prakash, Co-Founder, Ubiq. Over to you, Prashant, to moderate the session. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Vinay, for introducing the entire panel. I request Abhinav to showcase the slides. Hello everybody, I'm Prashant. Welcome everybody to the concept launch of Bharat One. This is a unique platform that today we are going to introduce. So everybody with me, get your seat belts tightened up. Let's get ready for the new concept launch of Bharat One. I would be taking a use case and I want everybody here on the session to be with me for a concept launch. Next slide, please. So this is a typical use case of a consumer Chetna. So everybody here, is everybody excited to see the journey of Chetna? Everybody on the chat box, I want a yes or no. Everybody on the chat box. Are you ready to see the concept? Oh, great, great. I'm getting a great response from everybody. Everybody's excited to see the journey of Chetna. Now let's take what the current challenges Chetna is facing. Chetna is a typical consumer who's living in Maharashtra. Now, Chetna today, for paying her bills, has to traverse to multiple places. She basically has to go to a biller collection point to pay her bills. She has to actually go to the, you know, her son's college to pay the fees of the tuition fees, etc. And also has to traverse to multiple touch points to pay her bill. In a very overall sad fact, Chetna's story is very sad because her entire day or month goes in paying bills, finding information, etc., etc. I mean, even today, we have a lot of consumers in India like Chetna who struggle to find information at one place. She doesn't know where to pay her tuition fee. She doesn't know where to go and find the books for her students. And that's the struggle today every consumer faces, right? From collecting bills to keeping a copy of that bills, filing them in, you know, that, you know, old boxes, are trying to search for the receipts whenever needed. And the journey, you know, goes on and on. How can we simplify, or how might we simplify the journey, has always been a thought that everyone, you know, wants to take care of. So going forward, today, even today, next slide, please. Even today, Chetna, if she wants a particular information about her son's college fees to pay, she calls a neighbor or she calls her son, where do I search the bill? Even if she wants to see and go for a particular hospital facility, she calls a friend. Is the nearby hospital good enough? Also, she refers to multiple apps or websites, start Googling up. Even then, if she wants a record copy of bill, she starts searching and rummaging all those bills. But the end answer is, she's still searching for answer at different places, not at a unified place. She still doesn't have the record copy. Whenever she wants to see a scorecard of her son, she still is struggling today. The end interface is very, you know, she's very sad story of Chetna. So there are many questions for her that are unanswered. Gas ka leakage hua hai. Do I get a resolution? No. Can I see my plans for DTH immediately? No. Because everywhere there is a struggle in her particular period of life. So going ahead, next slide. So there has always been a demand of solving how do we make the consumer life cycle of Chetna and many such customers easier. Right from the time the bill gets to your place till the time the receipt comes to your, you know, PDF or email, how do we solve the end journey? There's been a constant thought, constant, everybody is in the, you know, in the rush for solving the journey, but nowhere I feel they have come up with a unique solution of solving the 360 degree journey. And this is an attempt to actually solve the consumer life cycle going ahead. So as I said, right from the time the bill gets generated till the time the bill receipt comes to your house, we are always, the consumer is also seeking for problems and solutions. My bill is coming in my email. My receipt is coming maybe on a WhatsApp. My bill copy is coming in maybe through, you know, the letterbox at my home, or the resolution happens via call. Isn't there one platform solution for all queries and answers? Do I always have to depend on my friends, Google or Wikipedia for all information? Can't I have that all information at one place? We always here are talking about payments, but are we actually solving the life cycle of the customer? Audience, I want again on the Q&A chat box, I want an answer from here. Are we solving the life cycle of the customer? Yes or no? Is customer today given a 360 degree experience of all information at one place? I don't think, if you guys agree, you can type yes or no. No, no, I have been getting a lot of responses. So yes, the consumer journey is still unaddressed. He's still searching for problems and solutions, and he's unable to get that at one platform, one place. There is always a step before payments. Before I pay my tuition fees, I actually see whether the college is worth it, or do I, you know, does the college offer me placement? Before I move into a housing society, I search for multiple societies before coming to that particular society. So there are a lot of pre-steps that a consumer takes before actually doing a payment. And sometimes those pre-steps are unaddressed, and you know, those solutions are not easily found. So moving on to the next slide. So the idea here is, how do we give consumers a 360 degree overview of all information at one place? The idea is, today multiple apps, multiple platforms provide payment facility, but nobody provides information and service plus facility at one platform. So that's where today we are going ahead and launching the concept of Bharat One. Next slide, please. What is Bharat One? Everybody has heard about Prime Minister Narendra Modi having an aircraft, which is the Air India One aircraft, which was suited and modified to, you know, it is an interlinked model, which had multiple communication systems and etc. It had the best of resilience and best of infrastructure built onto that particular platform. Something similar is Bharat One. Bharat One is that similar Air India One, which is, has the best communication network, the best of the platform capabilities, and definitely interlinking the consumer journey on one arena. Now I launch the Bharat One in front of everybody. So 3, 2, 1,
with limited information. Are you struggling to switch between apps or websites to get a 360 degree purview of all services and information, but unable to get specific answers to your queries apart from payments? You need Bharat One, the powerful platform that will revolutionize the service ecosystem of Bharat. By empowering not only payment transactions, but interchange of communication between multiple banks, financial institutions, and end consumers. The solution seeks to expand the Bharat Bill Pay ecosystem beyond recurring payments. Bharat One would be the one-stop preferred lifestyle and all-services solution for the customer. Now, it's not just an electricity payment or education fee payment, but one can see his son or daughter's report card, or search for easy DTH plans, or even take a new gas or electricity connection. Information like, what is the customer care number? Can I get last 3 month bills? to consumer grievance, all is now available at one platform. The information before and after bill payment and various services a customer uses in daily life would be reflected in the Bharat Bill Pay supported applications or websites. Bharat One caters to multiple features of consumer journey, illustratively. New consumer onboarding. Bill information and bill in the box. Easy bill query and onboarding. Centralized information system. Consumer grievance and redressal. Bill receipt and payment. The consumer will benefit immensely with Bharat One, one-stop platform for all biller categories, services and solutions. Community to chat with and find info on any Bharat Bill Pay enabled app or website. Insights, bills, receipts, payments and more. And access to all information on one platform. Bharat One, Jankari Bhi, Payment Bhi. Powered by NPCI.
That's all Bharat, that's Bharat One all about. Bharat One is actually the one-stop platform which is going to solve the consumer life cycle of Chetna. Chetna today goes on a particular application of Paytm, PhonePe or Google Pay to do payments. Or maybe she goes to a Bheem app to do payment. But is she getting all the information at one place? The answer is no. Today, if Chetna wants to get all information, Bharat One would be that platform which would provide all information. Right from her customer, her students, her, you know, her own son's tuition fee bill, or maybe the scorecard of her tuition, or maybe the issues that she faces related to a gas leakage, the customer care number. If she wants to change the mobile number of her own on instead of going to the portal of gas, that would also be possible. If she wants to have one-stop solution of all people coming onto the platform and chatting on various nuances, that also possible. Multiple features on one platform. Today, everything is limited to a payment. Why is not the customer journey pre and post payment not addressed to? That's where Bharat One. So just a simple architecture, Bharat One platform similar to Bharat Bill Pay is envisaged to take input from multiple merchants and multiple billers in various categories. Like, can I see my DTH plan today? Can I see my electricity bill copy immediately? Is my 3 months bill available? So these are the various inputs that we collect from multiple billers across India through multiple APIs. The thought is to create a big API factory encompassed into one solution. Going ahead, we have some solutions and use cases. What are the major features of the platform? Some of the major features of the platform that are envisaged is definitely getting the bill copy immediately in the box. That's called the bill in the box. Receipt in the box. WhatsApp notifications by the biller. I'll just take a use case. I was talking to a particular consumer and he was finding it very difficult due to Corona to go to the a particular college and collect his scorecard. What happens if that particular college is able to send notification on his WhatsApp, the scorecard and details? Wouldn't that be easier? He doesn't have to travel so long and everybody is sitting in their hometown. It becomes very difficult to go back to that particular college and collect these scorecards and everything. If that particular school or college is able to send a PDF copy or the original on WhatsApp to the customer, wouldn't that be easier? Apart from that, customer will have multiple facilities like checking notifications, geo-targeted based facility. Is there a nearby agent where I can go and pay my bill? Language based facility, notifications, grievance, onboarding, past records of what my transaction is. All information is clubbed into one umbrella, one ecosystem, that is Bharat One. Going ahead, Next slide, please. What are the use cases that we have envisaged? So just taking an example of electricity and gas. Today, for a consumer, there is only one information, that is payment. But the idea is to have something more than payments. And that's how it is envisaged, like last 3 months' bill, information about the gas leakage number, chat for grievance and redressal. Can I see my new DTH plans? No, I am living, Chetana is currently living in a society where she's unable to go to that particular society for meetings. Can I see the updated meeting record? Chetana can actually go on to a Bheem app today or see the notification and updates of all her meetings only instead of paying the maintenance fee. Also, she could go and search for scorecard reports, stationery, new colleges, etc. So that's where the idea is of launching or going beyond payments. Now, without much ado, I will go and call my first partner, Mr. Vinay, who has helped us in developing the entire, Abhinav, we could go to the previous slide, please. I'm sorry. Yeah, so I would like to call my partner, Vinay Prakash, who would be basically explaining the details of the platform.
Hello and welcome, dignitaries. Thanks, Prashant. Thanks for a beautiful taking us through the beautiful journey of Bharat One. As the name suggests, hello. Am I audible now?
Yes, Vinay.
Yeah. So as the name suggests, this is another leap by NPCI towards singularity. We are trying to bring entire customer journey on a single platform because, you know, we essentially believe that, as Prashant has already explained, payment is just a small part of customer journey. And through Bharat One, we want to complete the circle of customer journey. If we say BBPS is a payments platform, we can very well say Bharat One is going to be the customer journey platform or customer experience platform. We are going to enhance customers' experience through this. Taking you a little bit deeper into technology, this is going to be a cloud-based workflow engine, kind of, where we will map workflows of upstream. My upstream will be the platform's upstream will be the merchants, the billers, the enterprises. Who wants to offer their services? BBPS, I mean Bharat One will be in the middle, kind of a middleware, and the same services can be mapped and consumed through APIs by downstream channels, maybe payment. I mean popular apps like Paytm or PhonePe or banking apps, and also through WhatsApp based and voice based channels. So this is kind of a middleware where we are, and the beautiful thing is these mappings can be customized. I mean the set of services, the set of workflows mapped by one or offered by one biller can be entirely different from other. I mean one insurance company can offer different gamut of services, another can offer different gamut of services. The platform will can cater to that. I mean, it will be fully customized, and downstream as well. A part of services can also be consumed by a distribution channel. I mean, Paytm or Bheem or any banking app. So upstream, the service providers, the gamut, the range of services can be customized. Downstream, who wants to consume it, that also can be customized. So it is not a standard services platform. I mean, like BBPS, you can play with a part of services, you can customize it. And needless to say, it'll be with all the authorization and authentication features. So, and one, right, right.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Vinay. Thanks a lot, Vinay, for, you know, really highlighting the entire thought of the platform to the end customer.
Right.
Now I would invite, I would tell the panelist that to invite Mr. Ritesh Khotari to showcase the demo of the voice-based platform.
Thank you, Hi, guys. Hi, I'm Nilesh, Nilesh Gopali. Me and my colleague, Ritesh, so we will demonstrate voice capability. But just before we go into that, thank you very much, Prashant. I'm excited and privileged to be a part of the Bharat One launch, and I would like to congratulate the entire BPPS team for this brilliant initiative, and we being a part of it, I can see that there's a lot of effort being put in. So without taking too much time, I would like to straight away give you the capability of the voice solution. Coming back to the use case that Prashant earlier alluded about is Chetna and her issues. So this is two use case that we will walk through. One of them where Chetna will do a bill payment in a sequential steps using sort of voice, where there is a transition. She's trying to learn how voice is to be used. The second use case is that of a postpaid bill mobile payment, where a single voice statement will allow her to make the entire payment. So Ritesh, could you please demonstrate the first sort of the use case where Chetna is doing the gas payment? On the screen that you can see is we are mirror imaging Beam app. Over to you, Ritesh. Thank you.
Gopali, just a small request. If you could just stop presenting for a while so that I can pin Mr. Ritesh on stage.
It's me who is presenting.
Yes, yes. So I would like to pin you on stage because...
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, Ritesh, you are on stage now. You may like to present.
Sure.
So, Ritesh.
Okay. So, good afternoon to everyone. I would like everybody to go on mute so that I can give the demo seamlessly. I hope everybody is able to see my screen.
It's yet to come. Go ahead.
Welcome to the voice assistance. Tell me, what would you like to do?
Gas.
Noted. There are three gas distribution companies. Please say one company to proceed. 1. Indraprastha Gas Limited. 2. Adani Gas. 3. Sabarmati Gas.
Indraprastha Gas Limited.
Hello. Welcome to the IGL service. Please select option.
Existing customer.
Please wait. Thanks. Here are the list of all the services provided by IGL.
Show all my pending bill.
Thanks. One pending bill. Summary below. Bill number 110001598261. Bill date, the 21st of February 2021. Bill due date, the 1st of March 2021. Total amount, rupees 1050.27. Would you like to pay this bill?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Please wait. Redirecting you to payment. Transaction completed successfully. Rupees 1050.27 have been paid for this bill. Please find below your IGL bill receipt. What would you like to do?
FAQ.
What information would you like to know?
What is customer care number?
1-800-102-5109.
What is gas leakage number?
155216.
What is domestic PNG rate?
Rupees 28.41 per SCM, including VAT.
Going back to home.
What would you like to do?
So we just completed the sequential steps. Ritesh, I would like you to take the second use case where Chetna is doing a mobile postpaid bill payment using just one sort of a statement.
Sure. Please pay my postpaid bill of Airtel.
On your registered mobile number, there is pending postpaid bill for March 2021 of rupees 200. Would you like to pay this bill?
Yes.
Redirecting you to payment. Payment of rupees 200 successful.
That completes our voice demonstration across two use cases. And I would like to hand over the baton back to you, Prashant.
Thanks a lot, Nilesh. I think indeed the entire thought of creating the voice-based platform has been really great. And to the entire audience sitting here, this what we saw is a live demo, not a recorded version. Live APIs flowing in, live demo happening in, live payment being done. So, you know, that's the beauty of the platform, that how seamlessly we have introduced the platform to Bharatvan. Thanks, Nilesh, for, you know, creating the entire thought of voice-based payments and, you know, and embedding that into the platform. Now I invite Abhinav Jain, who has been, has played a pivotal role in the system design and the entire thought of WhatsApp getting integrated with BBPS, has also been a pivotal part in the dashboards, etc. Over to you, Abhinav. I think the entire audience is waiting to see the live demo on WhatsApp. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Prashant sir. Hello everyone. I'm Abhinav Jain, co-founder and managing director of Fraser Enterprise. We are behind the system design of BharatOne platform. BharatOne is the one-stop platform that would empower customer with all the information they need. It is backed by artificial intelligence and natural language processing to extend the use cases beyond the payments. And to make use of these services, we are also working on WhatsApp platform. There would hardly be any person watching us who doesn't use WhatsApp. Today, WhatsApp is the primary mode of communication. Stakeholders or companies using WhatsApp services and payment offers limited functionalities over WhatsApp, but leveraging BharatOne platform, we intend to showcase you entire customer journey, right from onboarding the customer to getting the information to making the payment and downloading the receipt. Ease of all the services at one place. So now I would like to showcase you the live demo of WhatsApp. I'm sharing my screen. So here, our character from this particular play, Chetna, she wants to do all the bill-related details or get certain information. She would just open her WhatsApp and go to the WhatsApp chat. She can just say a hi or a hello message. On sending a hi or a hello message, BharatOne greets her with the languages options also. So since she is in Maharashtra, she can also talk in Marathi. For now, let's just go in the profile. So clicking on English. Now, if she has to go for each and every service, she has to go for different places. Like for education payment, she has to go for different place. For ask, she has to go for different place. So let's just go into one of the flow first. So I'm clicking on gas. I'm having certain options available now. So just a second.
Abhinav, I think there's a lag maybe in the presentation. Maybe you would want to take that ahead.
Yes, just a second.
Yeah.
So
it's sorry for doing that.
Yes. I think there's a lag in WhatsApp. So let me just. Okay. So here we got all the labels over here. So let us say we want to avail IGN services. So for IGN,
I think Abhinav, maybe if we could actually showcase them a live video of the transaction, it would be really great.
Yes, actually now the entire flow would work fine. Now let's just see, we are seeing all the services that are available from IGL over here. So all the services that are available from IGL that are showcased by VoiceKey also. So these all are backed by BharatOne platform. BharatOne platform provides all the services using a generic API that can be used, consumed by WhatsApp, voice-based assistant applications, or a normal application like Paytm or Google Pay. So here, what Chetna can do over here is, instead of going to a normal flow, when and send the photo of the bill. On sending the photo of the bill, our algorithm understands that this bill is of Indraprastha Gas Limited, and we have to look for the consumer number in the bill. Once we have the consumer number, we fetch the live details from IGL server, and IGL gives us back the information of Chetna. So Chetna's entire bill details, live details, are fetched up here. On this particular payment link, we are redirected to the payment gateway. On here, we have all the payment options available. We can go for any of one of the payment method. Since this is the test mode, so we can click on success. As soon as that is done, we should receive a payment receipt. So this is the payment receipt we got from IGL server. Now what we can do over here is, Chetna,
Abhinav, I think your screen is, Abhinav, just a second. I think the screen is not visible, maybe.
Is everyone else able to see my screen?
With your permission, Prashant, just to intervene, can I unpin Abhinav while
yes,
and pin him back? Maybe that can solve this.
Sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, sorry for the inconvenience and the technical glitch. I'll quickly try to pull Abhinav back.
No, Abhinav.
Yes,
Abhinav. Is everyone
back?
Can see.
Yeah. Is everyone able to see my screen?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect. Perfect. Sorry for the delay, but let's just go continue with the flow. So, Chetna, if she wants certain details on WhatsApp, she can click the mic button and say, "What's the customer care number of IGL?" On sending this particular information, she would fetch the live details from IGL server. So she get the details that the customer number of IGL is this. What else she can do? She can also ask for last bill transaction details. So when she asks for this, for which biller she wants asking for, So let's just say she is asking for Indraprastha Gas Limited or IGL. Then she's asked for her consumer number. And she got the details. Likewise, the flow is. Now, let's assume she wants to take a full body checkup or a test check, blood test checkup. She can also do avail all these services over WhatsApp. So she can just say a hi, this time in Marathi. So let's just say in Marathi, she wants to do a hospital or a pathology lab. She choose Thyrocare. Here she can book a new test or get previous test reports. So let's just book a new test for her. So she wants Thyrocare B plus. So she will select this. After that, she has to enter her name, her address. Now mobile number from which she is messaging will automatically pick up and she should receive a payment receipt. So on clicking on this payment link, she can make the payment for Thyrocare of 660 rupees. So she can just click on this, select the previous payment methods and make the payments. And as soon as she does that, she receives the payment receipt. Now education is something that is integrated to our daily life. Education is like almost half of our life spent in education from our childhood to our children's adulthood when they are till they are in colleges. So to avail these services over WhatsApp, the BharatOne platform provides education on WhatsApp. So here Chetna can see all her children's and she can select any one of them, whether they are from any different school also. So she selects one of them. She can make their fee payments. She can see their school alerts. Also students can check their marks card. So everything is possible over WhatsApp, even if they are from different school or in different colleges. Everything is available at one place. If I could sum up everything in one sentence, this is the BharatOne platform. Yaha payment bhi hai, jankari bhi hai. BharatOne, payment bhi, jankari bhi. Thank you. Over to you, Prashant sir.
A lot, Abhinav. The intent of the entire platform through WhatsApp was three. We showcased education of example where you're automatically getting the scorecard. The second use case of actually scanning the bill and getting the entire information. And the third use case is of even a voice being integrated into the WhatsApp face facility. Now I would like Abhinav to share the screen for the next presentation. That's where the platform is envisaged, because it's not only limited to be a payments. You saw various use cases, right from the customer care number being fetched in invoice to scanning a bill and doing a payment. You know, there are a lot of such features that are thought about. Also, we saw a WhatsApp based integration and voice based integration. Now to basically talk about the benefits of the platform and the technical architecture, I have with me the head and product development of BBPS, who's envisaged this entire platform. So Rahul Tennan, over to you.
Yeah, so good afternoon, everybody. And I'm sure what you've seen, how animated the panel has been, this has been something we have envisaged. We have tried to evangelize as something which would be a huge value from a customer journey perspective. So there's been a long debate where the entire economy, the entire fintech space, the entire customer space, customer convenience has been very excited about, digitalization of payments, formalization of payments. But one question we have always asked ourselves is, are we trying to segment and trying to analyze the last part of the customer journey? Because by the time the customer takes a payment decision, by the time the customer imagines a pricing decision, that is the last part of the customer journey. What it really requires is, like Prashant explained and Abhinav and Vinay, so and Nilesh through their voice app brought out what customer interaction can do. So basically, what we are looking is, on the one hand, you have what is known as all the billers or the merchants or the service providers who would want to directly reach out to their customers. The customers want to reach out to them through a ubiquitous platform, an interoperable platform where all kinds of services and payments can be engineered to, you know, emulsify in one place. The information can be brought to the BharatOne platform, and the interoperability of the platform puts us in a unique position to reach out across so many customer categories, consumer categories, biller categories, merchant categories, service categories, and basis a layered approach, an API approach, so many of these questions can be answered. So that is where we'll really understand the customer behavior, the consumer behavior, why is he taking certain digital decisions, what is leading to it. So what we always felt was that just the digital payments alone will not add value in the long run. And since, especially on the BPPS side, we have cut across so many categories, thousands of, billers already on board. But these are the questions we were getting from the market. The consumers reaching out and saying, how do I know my last bills? What is the next decision I can take? So I see this emerging gradually. A journey which we take along with the consumers and the service providers into a very, very, you know, strategic and a revolutionary platform. So can we go to the next slide? Yeah. So what is in for the consumer? So one single point access where a customer can meet all his needs in one place and not just payment decisions. It'll give the platform and the service providers key insights into customer behavior. We can create tribes, we can create buddy facilities where customers can necessarily not reach out to service providers. They can reach out to each other, share their insights, give a feedback. So we know where the service provider really stands, what is the supply side, can literally, you know, analyze the data and see what the customer really wants. You can create user groups around it. And like Vinay had so adequately explained, so this is how the customer touch points can literally customize for their customers on this platform. So we are looking at a public good platform, something which can create huge value for the supply and the demand chain points at any given point of time. Can I have the next slide? Okay, so what is the value proposition? And like the slide says, how do we unlock the new opportunities here? Will it merely lead to increase in number of transactions? We expect that to happen, which definitely from a revenue perspective, value perspective, is a huge opportunity. Will it also lead to more formalization of digital transactions? We definitely believe, because once a customer is on this platform, it does create a dependency quotient for him with regard to his queries being met and pricing decisions being taken. With regard to payment information, bill payment information, I'm not seeing this platform limited to that alone. But yes, I see this platform as a journey to this, where enhanced customer experience would lead to these decisions. Will the platform lend itself to chats and analytics and data? Of course, because right now all our segmentation may or may not be accurate because decisions have been taken before the payment decisions have been taken. And customer interaction with the service providers and merchants and within themselves, I'm sure it will create colossal data analytics. Supply side and the customer side can create their, you know, own use cases around it, extremely customizable. I see this a future of a very, very, you know, platform taking shape in a very strategic manner, literally becoming part of your lifestyle. One-stop shop for information, for service and for payments, which would be the end point of a very climatic journey. So this is how I would want to sum it at.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Now I would like, we would like to take the questionnaires answers posted in the chat box. The first question: so,
okay. So, so one of the question that has been posted is, can the voice be Indian and not Americano? So Nilesh, I would want you to take this.
I would like to answer that, as Nilesh is not on board as of now. He has a power cut there. So yes, the voice as of now, we are building for Indian different languages. Three of them are ready as of now, but definitely we will be developing it for multilingual. So it will be there in the future.
Okay. One query that has been posted on the chat box is, can we have an introductory note on Bharat 1 and how it can be extended? Yes, of course. Post this presentation and post the festival ending, we will be hosting on our website the entire note, the presentation, the feedback we have received, including the videos. And you can also connect to us offline because the team is young and very enterprising. And they will reach out and, you know, develop use cases along with whoever reaches out to us. What is the next one? Okay, there is a very interesting question. So can this bill information be shared with third parties or KYC purposes? That is purely a customer and prerogative, what they want to use it as. The only thing that probably would be needed to be taken is from a PII and a customer consent perspective before you use it for KYC, onboarding or sharing of data. You just have to take care that, you know, the privacy laws are taken care of, and rest is how you want to use this information. And I'm sure there'll be much more information beyond KYC which you would want to use. Okay, there is one is that how would you like to leverage public cloud payment infra for the platform? Leverage public cloud payment infra. So I think even better than me, Vinay is more equipped to answer this, but we are not merely looking at a payment cloud infra, right, Vinay? We are looking much more beyond that.
Yeah, much beyond that. It's just a part of payment cloud will be just a part of that. I mean, the very idea of Bharat One is to create an ecosystem beyond payments. I mean, we have many infrastructure which is only catering to payment. And this is an attempt to create a platform beyond payments. So I think this will be automatically a part of it.
Yeah, thank you. And the next somebody has posted is, what will be the value proposition for biller service providers to come on board Bharat One?
Yeah.
I see a lot of use cases. The billers and service providers, the ability to reach out directly to the customers. It is not merely B2B2C, it would become a B2C. On the customer side, the customer aggregators would probably also want this direct interaction. It could be a simple query on for an asset management company to, you know, change the tenor and tenure of somebody's SI auto being put up, or somebody would want to look at a plan MDM and, you know, make a choice of an insurance or an MFI product, or a simple electricity query. So there is a huge proposition. And apart from Bharat One, any which way, in BPPS, we are also introducing very powerful platforms like Unified Presentation Management System, which I'm sure we'll be dovetailing with this overlay service engine for a comprehensive business decision from a customer and a supply side perspective.
Just to add on, today a lot of billers, especially billers who are offline, like a municipality or a electricity board who doesn't have the capability to provide on information on their website, Bharat One becomes that one-stop platform to extend all information. Today they would not have a particular website or app where the all information is loaded, but Bharat One and all the apps enabled with Bharat Bill Pay becomes that one-stop communication for him to send notifications. It also actually reduces a lot of cost because he's integrating with a one-stop platform. So that's one benefit. The second question is how successfully B1 could be synchronized with SME business, basically Bharat One.
So we are seeing a lot of B2B businesses getting financed in the fintech space. We are seeing a lot of clusters emerging in the B2B space, especially in the SME space, because these clusters have not been really served from the point of view of automation services for a very long time. And we see increasing these clusters coming on, especially on BPPS, because they're very dynamic, they're not fixed payments, and they're irrespective of that. So Bharat One could be a great reach out between, let us say, retailer, distributor, SME cluster platform, where they could be, you know, even using this and on a very, very customized level to solve issues like their debtors and creditors, their invoicing and so many other service issues. Because in this case, a retailer distributor chain could be, you know, a customer to enterprise. So unlimited possibilities, depends on how you want to use it.
We'll take the last two questions. Right now, only a person who understands English is, so Mr. Narendra Gaur is talking about, is there a plan to available in all Indian languages? Yes, we have only shown this demo in English considering the time, but yes, it can be done in a multilingual facility. Even WhatsApp, even voice will have the, you know, the overall facility to provide multi-language to the end consumers.
So the idea is at least a key Indian, prominent Indian languages going forward would be dovetailed into the platform. 110%, we understand the importance of language and communication, that will be adequately taken care of.
Will BharatOne feature only benefit WhatsApp or all fintechs? The answer is all fintechs. So the thought is not only limited, the platform showcase demo was shown on WhatsApp, but tomorrow any app which is supported with BBPS or Bharat Bill Pay will have this feature of BharatOne, where all the information gets available onto the platform. Today, if you have a Bheem app, PhonePe, Google Pay, or any app or any net banking or mobile banking application, the idea is to extend that particular feature on all those applications.
So do we have any more?
So the last, can we withdraw money through QR code through ATM?
So this I don't think is very, very relevant to this demonstration.
Correct.
This can be taken offline, and that would again depend on the ATM providers if they can provide an access login through a QR code. So not exactly related to this demonstration. So these are the chats and the questions posted, which we have moderated. If there are none other, then I would probably want to sum this up by thanking the panel, thanking our partners, Ubik, Fraser, Voicekey. This is very, very conceptual, which we have taken forward and quite long in the making. But we believe that along with our partners, we see a very strategic initiative going forward. So if anybody wants to put in a last word, maybe Vinay, Abhinav, anybody, then we can sum this up.
Well, I think one point we missed out. This is the platform is going to be miraculous in a sense that this will start after some time, after a phase. This will start acting as your personal search engine. So all your personal belongings, personal documents, bill payments, receipts, previous spending, whatever, everything you can search here, because now it will carry a history of your journey through different billers, different merchants, different enterprises. So this is going forward is going to be your personal search engine kind.
Yeah, when I very well put.
Yeah,
it's a personalized Google.
We are going to be a threat to multiple silos working in different sectors. We would not like to name them, but then yes, that
definitely.
Yeah. But the silos can also come and get agglomerated here.
Yeah, they can become a part of us. Yes.
Definitely, yeah. And it would be much more bigger than Google, because in Google we have to search for all the facilities. And we are provided with lot of options. Here all the facilities are provided by the actual owners of that business. So whatever information we are getting, it's from the genuine resource. So definitely this information will be much more powerful and much more user friendly.
Yeah. So I think that is a very happy note and a very enterprising note. I think we can move back to the host and maybe sum it up, because I don't see any other queries being be posted there. Yeah, one last is there. Is this available as integrated API for other apps? That is the idea, because the API Rain Factory can get integrated and you can create your own USPs around it. So we'll be the service providers for that. I think we can...
Sorry, there is one more question regarding accounting and recording of these transactions.
This is a platform envisaged available for SMEs. How about thought of financing receivables?
Yeah, so if receivables are between, let us say, a retailer distributor chain, a supply chain, they can use this, because one side would be the guys who would be receiving those invoices or tradables. So it's your use case. Use your imagination and use it.
Thanks a lot. Thanks, audience, for staying tuned on Bharat One launch. It was indeed a great experience interacting with all of you. And, you know, we demonstrated the use cases of Chetna doing a WhatsApp-based payment vis-a-vis using a voice key. I would now hand it over to Vivek and Uday, who are moderating the event. For any updates, stay tuned on our social media channels and website for more information. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. On that note, I would like to thank Prashant, Rahul, Abhinav, Ritesh, Vinay, and Nilesh, who is not there with us, though he with his inputs and with everybody's inputs and showcasing how user-friendly this product can be for the masses. It was indeed a very enriching experience. I'm very sure the audience would have had a great time knowing and learning more about this product. With that, I would like to thank our partners and sponsors, Razorpay, Amazon Pay, WhatsApp, in association with Google Pay, Open Financial Technologies, and Cash Free Payments. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for taking out time and for this session. Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.